Creating a button in your Adobe Animate CC project is an essential skill because it's the one thing you can create to provide navigation for your users or audience. When creating a button, it's important that you remember that you need to create a button that's clickable and usable for all people, including people with disabilities. In this particular project, I have it stopped at frame 1, and I want people to be able to click on a go or a start or a play button that will then jump them to frame 2, which is the start of the animation. So in order to create that button, I need to have a layer for that button, a new blank keyframe, and then I just need to design something that works with this particular animation. So with that first keyframe selected on that go button layer, I'm going to grab a shape that I want to have in my button. So I'll choose an oval tool, and for right now I just want the fill color to be white, and I like drawing in object drawing mode, so I'll click that. On the stage, I'll go ahead and create the shape to make the button's base. And with every button, the key ingredient is the text, so people know what they're going to do or what's going to happen when they click that button. So I'll click the text tool, go to properties, and ensure I have the correct color font that I want, the correct size, etc. So I'll click and type go. Do a little reconfiguration here until it looks the way I want it to look. And I think that looks pretty good. So with this button, I have the base shape and the top text. Once I've created those two elements, I can highlight both of them, then go to Modify, Convert to Symbol, change the type to button, and then the way I like to name buttons is to do lowercase btn to indicate it's a button, and then use camel lettering for every word after that. So camel lettering means I'll capitalize the G in go and the B in button. Don't worry about the registration point or any of the advanced features. Just go ahead and click OK. Now that is a button symbol. You can go to the library and find that button symbol and see that it has a unique icon to indicate it's a button. That's not all we have to do with a button though. We want to provide rollover functionality so that people know it's clickable when they hover their mouse over it. In order to do that, we'll double click inside of that button and see that the internal timeline for a button symbol looks different than a movie clip or a graphic symbol. For a button symbol, we have the up state, so what it should look like when somebody is not clicking or hovering over it. The over state is what it should look like when somebody's mouse is hovering over it, and the down state is what it should look like when somebody's actually pressing down on it. Now the hit state is unique, it's invisible, but it indicates which part of the button is clickable. So right now I don't need a hit state because my base shape, this large circle, already creates a hit state for me, which means that if somebody's barely outside of this circle, it won't trigger. But the minute they get inside of this circle, it will trigger that rollover state and it will be clickable. We'll see an example of when you need to use the hit state at the end of the video. So I'll click on the over state and go to Insert, Timeline, Keyframe. And that will copy the graphics and the text from the first upstate keyframe. Now I can go ahead and click on that base shape, go to my color panel, and choose a color for the bottom of that button. Then I can go to the downstate, do the same thing, and go to Insert Timeline Keyframe. And again, it copies now that pink circle and the black text, and I can click on that circle and change that to a different color so it will change green when somebody clicks down. Now these are pretty garish colors and I wouldn't actually use it for this project because there are no colors like this in the project, but using garish colors sometimes will help us to see what's doing what and help us troubleshoot if we find a problem. So again, because I have that base shape, I don't have to worry about the hit state. So in order to test this out, we'll go back to the main scene. And I don't have any action script that's controlling that button, so if I tried to preview it in the movie, it wouldn't really work and it would jump to my animation and I wouldn't be able to actually try it and use it. So instead, what I'm going to do is with that button selected, I'll go up to the control menu and choose Enable Simple Buttons. Now don't forget that when you set this, It could affect what your actual project will behave like later. So only set this when you're testing and then turn it off when you're ready to actually publish your project. So we'll choose Enable Simple Buttons. And now when I hover over, you see it changes from white on the outstate to pink on the overstate. And when I click, it turns green. That's the downstate. So this simple buttons let me see if the actual states are working without any of the functionality of ActionScript. Now again, because that could mess up my project, I'll go to Control and uncheck Enable Simple Buttons. If you have more buttons to create, a good idea would be to duplicate the button and change the text after the fact. So to quickly show you an example of this, I'll right-click on the button and choose Duplicate. And this one I'm going to call BTN Stop Button. Make sure it's a button symbol and choose OK. So when we come over here, even though in the preview it still looks like the Go button, this is actually the Stop button. So I can double click inside of here, and the only thing I need to change is the text. So for each one of these, I will come in here and change the text. Now that doesn't seem very efficient, and also this text isn't going to fit. So I don't want to have to change this on every single button. So what I would recommend that you do is go to Edit, Cut, create a new layer for your text, and do Edit, Paste in Place to put it on the new layer and have it cover all three states. Then you can hide it and lock it so that you can go to the other states and get rid of that original Go and turn it back on again, and you can see now you have this stop text on each of the different states. Go back out. And there you've created a duplicated button in a few short seconds without having to reinvent and try to create the exact same shape at the exact same size with the exact same font and the exact same colors for each of the states. So it saves you a lot of time to be able to duplicate buttons. The last thing I want to show you with buttons is what you need to do with a hit state. So let's say you want a button that it's just text that is clickable. You can definitely do that. We'll go ahead and create a new layer. Just for the example, hit button, and we'll lock all the other layers, grab the text tool, choose a font color that's easy to see on this particular background, and we'll create our text. So let's create pause. Now the tricky thing without having a shape underneath it is if we don't add a hit state, whenever you have your mouse exactly over each one of these letters. Now, the bigger the letters, the thicker the font, the easier it's going to be. But imagine the font is something like that, and somebody who has limited motor ability in their hands is trying to click on it, and they have to get on exactly one of these pixels in the actual font. That's going to be really hard for them. So instead, what you need to do is add a hit state. So let's see what this is going to look like as a button. We'll go to Modify Convert to Symbol, BTN, pause button, make sure it's a button symbol, go inside of it, and for each of these states, I'll go ahead and hit F6 to create a keyframe, and I'll change this font color. So this one is going to turn pink when we hover over it. F6, which will be the down state, so I'll make this green, and we'll go back to scene one so you can see the simple buttons. Control, enable simple buttons. Now, when I'm off of that pause button, it's blue. And notice when I get really close to it, it triggers. But because the font is so big, that works. So when I get close to it, it triggers that rollover and we see the pink. And when I click, it turns green. But again, if this button was really small, that's going to be harder for people. Oops, we need to shut off the enable simple buttons first. It's going to be harder for people to click. So I'll go ahead and make this smaller. And if I try that again, control enable simple buttons, and they try to get to it, they might not get right on it. So if that happens for you, what you can do, let's shut off the simple buttons, is you can get inside of that button and you can choose a hit state. Now the hit state is invisible. So generally you want to create a shape that's about the size of your text or a little bit bigger. You don't want to create something massive that's really going to trigger no matter where the mouse is. So I just want to show you an example of this. So on the hit state, I'll go ahead and just create a new blank keyframe. So insert blank keyframe, and I'll create a shape over that particular text. So it was about there. So now when I go back to scene one, I can enable the simple buttons. And when I go near it, see how it triggers a little bit further away, even up here? That hit state created a clickable area that was a little bit bigger than the actual word. So that's going to be a lot easier for people who have maybe motor disabilities, or they have visibility issues, or even just people in general. It's hard when people have, you know, you have to click on a specific area. We just want it to be easy and we can quickly do it. So that's the basics of creating buttons. Now you need to learn how to add ActionScript to control those buttons, or so that they can control your timeline or do things like visit an outside website. To learn that, check out that very topic on my YouTube channel.